Hey everyone, thanks for joining me on today's video. On today's video, we're going to be starting on making a aluminum frame bicycle camper trailer. And today, we're going to start utilizing some metal that I kind of found at a roadside curb score, I guess you could say. It's triangle tubing. It's roughly about, I'm gonna say about a 16th, or maybe like a 332 wall, and yeah, I'd say about more like a, I don't know, it's just under an eighth thick anyways. I think it's gonna be more than sturdy enough for what we're using it for. It's quite thick there. So this is an IKEA bed frame. Let's see if we can check out the label right here. Focus. Baden, Sweden. IKEA. So, right now the ends on the longer pieces, which are roughly about 7 feet long, they are 45'd on one end, on the what was, I believe, the bottom end or the foot end of the bed. And so we're going to be leaving them like they are. And right here is the bottom rail, I believe, probably where the boards or slats used to sit. Those are going to be for a bottom storage area underneath the deck. I'm going to see if I could get the deck basically flush with the top of here. So I might just put like weld some sort of edge right in here, just the thickness of the boards or whatever, so I could throw some boards on top. Anyways, and this is the foot end piece. It is, I believe, 45 on both ends. So essentially, it'll be sitting like this. It'll be sitting like that. And this part that you see with the ribs on it and the holes on it will be on the inside of the trailer. The slanted 45 going up part will be on the outside of the trailer. So yeah, this piece is quite a bit shorter. By the time I finished slicing it on the line, which I already have marked out here, basically halfway, the whole trailer should be about 7 feet long and just under 3 feet wide to the very outside corners. So anyways, without further ado, I'm gonna throw this piece in my my chop saw over here. This is Evolution compound miter saw. It is a multi-material saw. It is made for slicing through steel tubing, aluminum. As long as it's on the lighter side, it's fine. But it was basically marketed as a multi-material saw, so I can cut through PVC, aluminum, a light steel tubing, whatever, and it does cut through it like butter. It runs a lot slower than most other miter saws. It's built a lot firmer and tougher than most other wood miter saws. And it has a nice soft start feature. And it does, see if I can get a shot on it. Maybe not. You can barely see it right there. It does have a steel cutting blade. Anyways, I'll get the piece set up in the saw, and let's get cutting, and let's just start getting all the pieces together for this bicycle trailer. All right, hang on, I'll get you in the holder.